Earlier, we have discussed about the slaughter and dressing of different food animals, and side by side we have discussed about the post-mortem inspection. Once the post-mortem inspection is done and the carcass is found to be fit for human consumption, carcasses will go for final washing and then chilling. Now we start from here. Carcasses of different species need to be evaluated and graded. So today's topic is grading of carcasses, or sometime grading and evaluation of carcasses. An introduction: meat industry aim to produce carcass with high quality, palatable, lean and least amount of fat and bone. Slaughter of these animals is widely practiced art for evaluating their value at market, mainly based on visual appraisal of carcass, characteristics of the animals for specific purpose. A good judge should be familiar with the anatomy of animal, terminology and location of high priced wholesale cuts. So actually, wholesale cuts or fabrication of carcasses is a very related topic with this. So sometime I will mention, but the details we are going to discuss in the next lecture. Carcass grading. Carcass grading is a procedure by which carcasses are segregated on the basis of expected palatability or yield attributes. Mostly USDA, French, British and Canadian grading system are popular. However, all of them are based on certain common quality attributes. In India, meat grading has been carried out under the raw meat, that is chilled or frozen, grading and marketing rules 1991. The specification for buffalo meat, veal and mutton is mentioned in Schedule 1, 2, 3 respectively of the above rules. Now, importance of carcass grading. Evaluation of carcass quality and composition is important to producers, meat packers and retailers, and also for the consumers. Consumers desire cuts that are lean, nutritious and possess desirable eating characteristics. Meat researchers have developed reliable factors that influence eating quality and yield of lean cuts. Using these evaluation techniques, producers and packers can produce and sell carcass that meet consumer demand. So this evaluation and grading is very important for both the producers and consumers to be satisfied with their product. Purpose of evaluation. This is to assist the producers in producing high quality carcasses, producing high yielding carcasses, identifying superior lines of breeding stock and promoting a desirable product. So in one side, it is a support for the producer to improve their production quality or quantity wise. So purpose of grading, in continuation to the previous one, in the left side we see what is grading. That is to segregate the products into standard groups with common characteristics such as appearance, physical properties and eating quality. So this is one of the idea to classify the product based on certain desirable characteristics, and how it helps to facilitate the marketing through standardization of product that is valuable to consumers. So this grading helps both the producer or seller and the buyer or the consumer. Both should be satisfied with their product and their selling price or their buying price. Here we will see the different aspect of carcass grading. You can see the grades. There is two kind. One is yield grade, another is quality grade. Yield grade is mainly indicating the quantity of meat expected from a carcass, whereas quality grade is based on the eating quality. That is the characteristics or how we like the meat. On that anticipation, it is graded as quality grade. Now in the yield grade, there are types like we will discuss about the beef, sheep, goat and pig carcass grading. And the factors for ill grading are like mostly three important: measurement of fat, muscle development and carcass size or weight. In the right side, in the quality grading, again the types we will discuss for beef, sheep and goat and pig. And here the factors for ill grading are kind, class, maturity, color, marbling, firmness, structure, conformation, fleshing and finish. Some of these things we are going to discuss in more details, the factors in for the ill grading and the factors for the quality grading we will discuss little bit more details later. As I told previously, there are few important factors for ill grading. Mostly three are important. One is measurement of fat amount. So this is measured in different location in different species. I will be telling in that particular time. Then there is a measurement of muscle development. By different way, muscle development is measured or assessed at different location. And third is the carcass size and weight. So here either we can measure the length of the carcass or we can measure the weight of the carcass. So based on these three criteria, we get an idea about amount of meat available from a carcass and from which we make a yield grading. Now we will see the factors for quality grading. Quality means about the meat quality, how it is going to be the satisfactory for meat eating or the sensory quality aspect. Based on that, so these parameters are like kind and class. Here the kind indicates the different species of meat and the class is the subdivision of the same species, either depending on the age or sex. The maturity, this is indicating about the biological age of the carcass. Number three is color, that is very important in case of meat, that gives an idea about the quality of meat. Marbling, this is the intramuscular fat deposition. We are going to discuss in more details later. Firmness, this is about setting of the carcass. When we keep it for chilling, the muscle and the fat get some kind of solidification and gives a strength. And the color and structure of the lean, this I have already mentioned. And the conformation or fleshing and finish. So conformation indicates the proportional growth and development of the whole body in relation to the muscle and the bone and the skeleton. And sometimes the finish, that is indicating about the fat deposition at different part of the carcass. As I told earlier, we are going to discuss the carcass grading for different species separately. So now first we will discuss about the beef carcass grading. For doing that, we should have some idea about the cutting pattern, or it is called wholesale cuts or primal cuts. This is a separate topic I am going to discuss in the next lecture in more details. For brief understanding, the beef carcasses, as you know, it will be split into two halves, and each halves will be first cut at the middle to get a fore quarter and hind quarter. Now from the fore quarter, we get four cuts like chuck, brisket or shank, rib, loin, flank, and sometime loin is cut into sirloin. And the first, actually at between 12th and 13th rib, the carcass will be separated. Here it is not very clear. And the thigh with leg portion, which is also called as round. In beef, we will discuss it in two categories. One is for cubs below 1 year, another is for above 1 year. So based on age, cubs are of two categories. Below 3 months, they are called as veal, and 3 to 12 months, they are called as calf. Whereas based on weight, this veal and cubs both are subdivided into three categories. In case of veal, it is light. If it is below 50 kg, then 50 to 80 kg medium, and above 80 kg heavy. In case of cubs, up to 90 kg, it is light. 90 to 136 kg medium, and above 136 kg it is called heavy. Now we will discuss about the beef above 1 year. Here they are first divided into subcategory, as I said, class, kind and class. Beef is the kind and the subcategory is class. So based on sex. They can be heifer, steer, cow, bull, age. Then we have two kind of grading. I already told, one is for ill grading, we will discuss for this beef cattle. And there is quality grading, mostly for steer and heifer. Then there is slaughter beef, and ill grading we will discuss, or quality grading we will discuss in case of steer and heifer. Now we will discuss about the factors of beef grading. Earlier I have mentioned for the ill grading and quality grading factors, those are common for all species, but now we will see it specific for beef. So in case of quality grading, the factors, as I told earlier, kind and class, maturity, marbling, firmness, color and conformation, fleshing and finish. In case of quantity grading or yield grading, mainly three, that is amount of external, internal and intermuscular fat, in which the marbling is most important, that is the intramuscular fat. Then second important factor in yield grading, that is the muscle development. And the third factor is size and weight of the carcass. Sometimes there are other additional factors taken into consideration, like type, yield or dressing percent, carcass merit, balance, style, smoothness. As I have already told, for understanding the grading, we need to know the wholesale cutting pattern. Here it is once again explained how the carcass is cut. I am going to tell in details in the next lecture. Here we will see the yield grading of beef. As I told, there are three main criteria for yield grading. One of the important criteria is the yield of the lean meat from the four important cuts. So based on that, this is the USDA grading system. We can see here that there are five yield grade, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. USDA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is based on the yield of the carcass from the four cuts, as I have told earlier, that is the round, rib, loin and chuck. These four cuts together, what is the yield? That is the criteria for classifying. So in case of grade 1, it is 52.4% or more. The grade 2 is 50.5 up to 52.3. Grade 3 is 47.8 and above. Grade 4 is 45.5 and above. And grade 5 is 45.4 or less. Side by side, it is telling here in the right side about the percent retail cuts from the carcass. So this kind of grades, the animal will be lighter weight in case of grade 1 and lean and heavily muscled. Whereas grade 4 and 5, the lowest grade, they will have heavier animal, looks very fatty, light muscles development. Here you can see the photographs of five different yield grades, that is the yield grade 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Here we are seeing a very specific parameter for yield grading, that is called rib eye area, or also called as loin eye area. So this is a cross section between the 12th and 13th rib, which makes a section on the longissimus dorsi muscle. So once we cut both sides at the vertebral column, it gives an eye-like structure, and there is a stressing done of this area. Whole area is marked, and that is measured with a special instrument called planimeter, and that gives an idea about the muscular development. As I said, muscle development is one of the criteria for yield grading. So this helps in yield grading, and there are some techniques by using this. So the longissimus dorsi muscle area is also called as rib eye area or loin eye area. Now we will see the quality grading for beef. The quality grades indicate the factors related to the sensory characteristics of tenderness, flavor, color, texture and juiciness. So sometimes we call them as eating quality. So this grading is based on the quality at the time of eating. The quality grade is intended to reflect the cooked product's overall acceptability. So in USDA grading system, which is very popular, it has got 8 different grades in quality grading, that is prime, choice, good, standard, commercial, utility, cutter and canner. So this grading mainly done on two criteria. One is the maturity, another is the marbling, which we are going to discuss in more details later. In USDA grading of beef, the maturity is categorized into 5, that is A, B, C, D, E, based on the age. So A means 9 to 30 months, B 30 to 42 months, C 42 to 72 months, D 72 to 96 months, and E beyond 96 months. Now, since we are talking about quality grading, so age is very important factor. Once the age is very high, the muscle become very tough, so the meat will not be of good quality. So in quality grading, the little bit lower age is very important. We are going to see later. As I said, in quality grading USDA, the prime, choice, select and standard, these four category of grade are related to the lower age. So are the age of young cattle under 42 months of age, that is A and B maturity. The remaining four grade, that is commercial, utility, cutter and canner, they are the grades for aged cattle, that is the ages C, D and E, that is above 42 months of age. So in beef quality grade, as I told, the two main criteria, one is the maturity, another is the marbling. So now we will see what is marbling. Marbling is the fat within the muscle, or it is also called intramuscular fat, and is evaluated in the ribeye between the 12th and 13th ribs. That is the cross section of the 12th and 13th ribs between these two ribs. And that area, if we see that, we can see the fat deposition in the cross section of the L dorsi muscle. So beef cuts with high levels of marbling are more likely to be tender, juicy and flavorful than the cuts with very low levels of marbling. So marbling makes the meat more tender and flavoring. We are going to see more details about the different subcategory of marbling. Here we will discuss little more details about the marbling. In USDA, they have 10 different subcategory for marbling, that is abundant, moderately abundant, slightly abundant, moderate, modest, small, slight, trace, practically divide and divide. So there will be standard color chart available. By the cross section of the ribeye area, you can see in the right side figure, there is a white streaks of fat deposition in between the muscle. So there will be standard chart available. Here we are seeing the 2 to 7. These are the best preferred, whereas the most high amount, that is abundant, is not a desirable. 2 to 7 are more desirable. So this is shown in this figure. There will be 10 such color chart available. Whenever we make a cross section, we can compare with this color and decide the category of marbling. This chart is to explain the relation between the marbling and maturity and how the quality grades are done. As I told, in case of maturity, there is A, B, C, D, E, depending on the age of the animal from which the carcass has come. And the marbling, I told 10 category, but the first and second is not taken here, from the third, that is slightly abundant. Now I have already told there are 7-8 different grades in quality grading of beef as per USDA. Now the best grading is the prime. If you see the shade, that is indicating that slightly abundant marbling and the maturity is A and B. This is the criteria to be prime. Then next is the choice. So here the marbling is moderate, modest and small. You must see the shaded area, uniform shaded area. And here the age is A and B. Then the select. This is slightly marbling. That is, marbling is very less. Though age is at the A category, but marbling is very less, so it is a lower grade. Then in the next standard, it is having a marbling of traces and practically divide and age up to A and B. So sometimes small and slight marbling, but age is B, so it is going to standard. Then the next one is the commercial, so which is covering the C, D and E, that shaded area C, D and E. So between B and C, there is a sharp disconnection with the dark line. C, D, E, though they have got better marbling because of the age, it is a lower grade. Then the utility. So this is again the lower, very low marbling, and age is also high. And the, finally the cutter. So here there is no marbling actually. It is below zero or zero. And the age is also high. So that is the lowest. Sometime there is another grade called canner. Now we will discuss about the carcass grading for sheep and goat carcass, or sometime it is commonly called as lamb grading in USA. So before going to it, we should know roughly about the wholesale cuts of sheep and goat, which we will discuss in the next lecture. Here briefly you can see in the picture, the leg portion is called as leg, and then there is the loin, rack, the shoulder, shank, or sometimes shank with brisket. So these are a little bit connected with the grading. In sheep and goat carcass grading, some of the important parameters like live weight, which is very important economic trait and leading to a better quality carcass. Then dressing percent, it is estimated as the carcass weight percent on the live weight. Sometimes the carcass weight and the edible organ weights are added with that. Then fat thickness, that is a measured at the 12th rib region. Then body wall thickness, this is measured at about 4.5 inch from the midline of the ribbed lamb. And the loin eye area, which I have already explained earlier, that is the cross section area between 12th and 13th rib of the longissimus dorsi muscle. Here we will see the sheep carcass evaluation, some of the parameters I told previously, and they are standard values. The live weight expected to be 105 to 130 pounds in case of large goat. Then dressing percent 44 to 56%. Then fat thickness 0.05 to 0.5 inches. Body wall thickness 0.6 to 1.25 inches. And loin eye area, this is the square inch, 1.5 to 3.5 square inches. Here we will see the yield grades as per USDA in case of sheep. Actually, they have 5 grades, yield grade 1 to 5, that is having 2 criteria. The grade 1, that is the fat thickness and the percent of the 4 important cuts, that is the leg, loin, rack and shoulder. The first grade, the thickness of fat is 0.15 inch and less, and the weight percent is 47.4. Whereas in case of grade 5, we can see it is less than, I mean more than 0.46 inch, the fat thickness is more, and the yield of the 4 important cuts is less, that is 41.9 or less. So that is how the 5 yield grades are established in case of sheep as per USDA. Now it is about quality grading in sheep. Basically 3 different criteria is looked into. Number one is determined by evaluating the joint at the bottom side of the canon bone. So that shows about the maturity or towards the age and the quality of meat. The second is looking at intramuscular fat, that is the marbling we have already discussed earlier in case of beef. And the third is the overall assessment of muscling or muscle growth, and the forehead will be broad, thick neck, short leg, and deep and wide body. So these are the criteria for quality grading in case of sheep. Here is the lamb or mutton quality grades as per USDA. Mostly there are 4 grades. The best one is the prime, and then the choice, which is most common, and then good and utility. Here is the quality grades in goat as per USDA. Basically, they will have 3 classes, maybe same for sheep also, that is the kids below 12 months, then yearling, that is 12 months and above, and the adult goat. So in all the case, there are 4 grades as per USDA, that is the choice, good, standard, and utility. Here we will see about the USDA quality grades. As I already told, they have the 4 grades, that is the prime, choice, good, and utility. and this is determined by three factors. One is the maturity, indicated by the joints, then the flank fat streaking, that is the deposition of fat in the intercostal muscles, and the third is the conformation. So we can see some idea by seeing the picture in the top. That is the joint, depending on the age, it is called as break joint or spool joint. Here we will see about the maturity in case of LAM quality grading as per USDA. They have three class, that is the LAM, that is up to 12 months, then mutton between 12 to 24 months, and mutton over 24 months. In maturity, the class is determined on two aspects. One is the joint, that is the when that joint breaks, that is called animals, and when it is not breaking, that is called spool joint in case of old animal. And in case of ribs, if it is red and round, then it is young, and if it is opaque and flat, then it is old. That is how the maturity is decided to determine the quality grades of sheep as per USDA. Here is another important criteria for quality grading of lamb, that is the flank fat streaking. This is the streaks of fat deposit at the flank muscle. So flank fat is a visible deposit within and upon the surfaces of the primary and secondary flank muscles. So depending on the quantity of fat deposition, it has got 9 subcategory, that is abundant, moderately abundant, slightly abundant, moderate, modest, small, slight, trace, and practically devoid. Now we will discuss about pork carcass grading, for which we should know the wholesale cuts of pork carcass. Basically, there are 4 main cuts. The thigh and leg portion is called as ham, and then the top large portion loin, and below that it is whole portion is called as belly or bacon, and then the up shoulder portion is called Boston butt, and lower leg of the shoulder is called the picnic shoulder, and in the front there will be a small portion of jowl and the head. So this is important for the grading purpose to know. Here is some of the important factors for pork carcass grading. First one is the class, that is the within species subcategory depending on the weight or the sex. So in this case, most common classes are barrow, gills, sows, boars, and stags. Then the next is the back fat thickness, which is very important in case of grading of pork carcasses. And then the degree of muscling, the overall muscle development. Number 4 is the color of lean, that is the color of the lean muscle. Then number 5 is the firmness of fat and lean. And the last one is the belly thickness. These are common criteria for grading of pig carcasses. Here is the pork yield grading based on some of the parameters I have already told. Roughly here it is into 3 categories, that is excellent, average, and poor. The carcass length in centimeter when it is 72.5 and above. Average means 71.25 and poor means 67.5 and below. The dressing percentage when it is above 73%, it is excellent. Then up to 71 centimeter, it is average. And when 69 and below, it is poor. Then the ham and loin cuts together, how much percent it makes. If it is more than 40%, excellent. When it is 35 and above, it is average. And when it is 30 and below, it is poor. Then percent of 4 lean cuts, as I told earlier, if it is more than 58%, then it is excellent. When it is 50 and above, it is average. And when it is 44 and below, it is poor. Then loin eye area, as I told earlier, the square centimeter in this case, when it is 31 square centimeter and above, then it is excellent. 23 and above, it is average. And 18.75 and below, it is poor. Then the back fat thickness in millimeter, if it is too high, it is a lower grade. So only when it is 30 millimeter and below, then it is the excellent. When it is 40 and up to 30, then it is average. And when it is more than 50, then it is poor grade. Here is the yield grading of pork carcasses as per USDA. So in the USDA, pork grade is a numerical presentation of the percent of yield of bone in four lean cuts. That is the ham, loin, Boston butt, and the picnic shoulder. These four cuts together, what is the percent? That gives the criteria for grading of the yield grading of pork. So in this case, there are four grades, that is US 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the percent of these four lean cuts is when 60.4 and above, number 1, then 60.3 to 57.4, number 2, 57.3 to 54.4 is the number 3, and 54.4 and below, that is the US grade 4. Now here we will discuss about the quality grading of pork carcasses. Here mainly three criteria. One is the carcass length, number two is the fat thickness, that is measured at the last rib, and number three is the degree of muscling, the muscle development. Based on these three criteria, the quality grading is done. You can see in the picture at the right, it is showing the measurement of length of carcass and also the place for measuring the fat thickness. And in the middle photograph, it is showing the assessment of the loin eye area, muscle area, which is indicative of muscle growth. And in the top right, it is showing the carcass thickness. That is the three category: thick, average, and thin. Here is a quality grading of pork carcass based on back fat thickness. Actually, as per USDA, there are four grades, but here the grading based on back fat thickness, there are five grades: 1, 2, 3, medium, and cull. In this case, in number 1, you can see the thickness is 1.5 to 1.9 inches, and number 2 is 1.9 to 2.3 inches, and number 3, 2.3 and above, whereas the medium, where it is less than optimum, then it is a lower grade. And when it is still less than 1.1 inches, still it is a lower grade. Next, we will see the USDA grading, that is the quality grading 1 to 4. Here is the USDA quality grades for pork carcasses. There is 1, 2, 3, 4 and utility. Number 1, we can see the length, that is 30.4 inches. Then the back fat thickness 1.3 inches and the muscling is thick. Number 2, the length is less and the back fat thickness is more, 1.6 inches, and muscling is moderately thick, not so thick. Number 3 is length further less, 29.5 inch, the back fat thickness further high, 1.9 inch, and muscling is further less. And in the fourth category, length is 28.5 inches, further less, thickness, back fat thickness is still more, 2.2 inches, and the degree of muscling is still very less. And the utility is the last category, where all these parameters are below this. Here we are almost at the end. This is a summary table for the different carcass grade as per USDA for different species. So in the beef grades, there are three class, that is steer, heifer, and cow. And they have the grades like prime, choice, good, standard, commercial, utility, cutter, and canner. I have explained earlier. Then in case of bullock, there is five grade: prime, choice, good, standard, and utility. In case of calf, there is five grade: prime, choice, good, standard, and cull. In case of lamb and mutton, there is three subclass, that is the lamb and yearling, that is they have got five grades, that is prime, choice, good, utility, and cull. In case of yearling, that is 1 year and above, yield grading, that is US number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in case of mutton, there is the quality grading, choice, good, utility, and cull. In case of pork carcasses, for stag or gilt, there is the US number 1, 2, 3, 4, and utility. This is the quality grading. And in case of sows, there is the grading based on back fat thickness. I told US number 1, 2, 3, cull and medium. So this is the summarized different grades as per USDA. So this is the last slide before I summarize. This is the carcass grading as per BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standard. In case of mutton and chibon, BIS specifies or recommends the grading based on length of carcass, thickness of back, fullness of legs and flank, and amount of fat in the intercostal muscle. This is in case of sheep and goat. In case of beef, the grading is recommended based on conformation, finish and quality. But I am not going in details about the grades as per BIS. And in case of pork, it is based on length, dressing percent, yield of 4 lean cut as it is given in case of USDA, and the back fat thickness. It is almost similar as USDA. So this is briefly how the grading is recommended in case of BIS, but I am not going in details about it. Now we are at the end of today's lecture, that is about the grading and evaluation of carcasses. We have discussed what is carcass grading, what is the purpose, what is the different criteria, and how it should be done in case of different species like beef or sheep and goat, and in case of pork carcass. As such, this is a very, very big and vast topic. There are several full-fledged books only on carcass grading or livestock grading and marketing. But this is very, very precisely I have presented mostly for the undergraduate students, but it is also enough for the postgraduate students, but they should see some more details from the lecture notes and which I have already given. Thank you for listening to the lecture.